Hi everybody, this is Rishi Agarwal. In this video, I want to show you another eye test. I'm going to give you a few moments to look at the frontal radiograph. I don't want to show you the lateral radiograph just yet. Did you see the abnormality? Some of you may have noticed that there are these nodular opacities in the peripheral right hemithorax. Note that these overlap multiple ribs, and for some of these opacities, like this one, there's an associated cortical step-off in the bone. These are callus formation from multiple rib fractures, and that's not the answer to this eye test. The abnormality that I wanted to show you is right here. If you look behind this gas bubble from the splenic flexure of the colon, you'll notice a round lesion through it. And before I show you the lateral view, I want you to think about what anatomical space this is in. Okay, now let me show you the lateral view. Notice that there's this round opacity right here superimposed over the spine. That puts this lesion in the left lower lobe. And there's two radiographic signs I want to go over for this case. One is called the thoracoabdominal sign, and this was coined by Ben Felson decades ago. And basically it says that if you have an abnormality that you can see through the diaphragm, it's in the posterior chest, typically the lower lobe. And the reason for that is the diaphragm slopes down going from anterior to posterior. So there's a lot of lung behind the apex of the diaphragm, which we can clearly see on this lateral view. If we draw a horizontal line across the top of the left hemidiaphragm, you'll see that this lesion is under that line. Now, if we just had this frontal view, could this be material in the colon? Yes, this could be fecal material in the colon, but what makes it unusual for that is that usually fecal material has speckled foci of air inside of it, and this is more homogeneous without air. That's what would make me think that this abnormality is not in the abdomen, but in the lung. On the lateral view, there's another sign called the spine sign. As your eye moves from superior to inferior over the spine, it should go from more dense to less dense. That's because the relative amount of soft tissue compared to lung is greater in the upper chest compared to the lower chest. But if you have disruption of that gradient, in other words, if you have a density where it should become more lucent, that should make you think that there's an abnormality in the lung or possibly in the pleura or spine itself. In the case of a lung density, it could be a consolidation like pneumonia, or it could be more round like in this case. Let me show you the CT. Before I show you the axial images, let's take a quick look at the scout image. You can see the lesion right here behind the heart, and what you'll notice is that the top of the lesion is above the top of the left hemidiaphragm, whereas on the frontal radiograph, the entire lesion was below the diaphragm. The reason for that slight change is that on the CT scan, the patient is in the supine position, and on the radiograph, they were standing upright. So those differences in patient positioning will lead to slight changes in the relative position of anatomical structures. Let's go back to our thoracoabdominal sign. That sign says that if we see the abnormality through the diaphragm, some or part of the borders of the lesion through the diaphragm, it must be in the posterior chest and typically in the lower lobe. Previously, we hypothesized that this could be something that's in the colon, but because it's peaking up above the diaphragm on this scout image, we can definitely say that it's not in the colon or in the stomach and that it must be in the chest. Also notice the consistency of the fecal material in the transverse colon here. We have speckled foci of air throughout the colon, whereas this lesion is fairly homogeneous without air. Now let's take a look at the axial images. On the axial images, you can see that there's a mass in the left lower lobe with spiculated and irregular borders. It's behind the left hemidiaphragm, And this was biopsied, and it was shown to be a poorly differentiated primary lung adenocarcinoma. Also note its position relative to the spine. On these axial images, we can more fully understand why it causes an abnormality that is superimposed over the spine on the lateral radiograph. Let me show you a quick companion case. Here's the frontal radiograph, and I'm not going to show you the lateral radiograph just yet. Hopefully you all see the abnormality. There's a rounded lesion projecting over the right hemidiaphragm on the frontal view. There's also a bit of blunting of the right costophrenic angle, indicating a pleural effusion. Now, where would you predict this rounded lesion to be? Is it in the upper lobe, middle lobe, or lower lobe? Remember that the thoracoabdominal sign tells us that if you see all or part of the borders of a lesion through the diaphragm, then that lesion has to be in the posterior chest and typically in the lower lobe. There's very little lung, if any, that's anterior to the diaphragm. So that's why it has to be in the lower lobe. So without even looking at the lateral view, I can tell you that this lesion is in the right lower lobe. Here's the lateral view, and it confirms our suspicion that this lesion is in the right lower lobe. We also have a positive spine sign, which is an area of increased density where we would expect the spine to be more lucent. We also have blunting of the right costophrenic angle, confirming our suspicion of a small right pleural effusion. This is the CT for that patient, and this too was a lung adenocarcinoma. Okay, let's review what we learned today. We looked at the thoracoabdominal sign, we looked at the spine sign on the lateral radiograph, and we reviewed one of the radiographic blind spots on the chest x-ray, which is lesions in the retrodiaphragmatic region. So when you're looking at your chest x-rays, be sure to pay special attention to any lesions that could be hiding behind the diaphragm. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about this topic or any other chest radiology topic, let me know in the comments below. Thanks.